opinion, the main two factors that will affect oncology in the coming years are machine learning, which is a branch of artificial intelligence, which will allow oncology experts to be in every hospital, because we will be able to train neural networks with the best oncologists that exist. And this will allow us to bring those oncologists to everybody. And the second main technology difference that I think will happen in the future that will help oncology will be the fact that personalized medicine will take off. And this is both in terms of genetics, so people who are more susceptible to certain cancers, but also people who are influenced by their lifestyle, so that we can bring these knowledges together, and that will help us predict whether someone's going to get cancer and to treat it more quickly, which will help improve survival rates. I think for industry to adapt to keep up with the innovation process, what it needs to do is really keep a lookout at the new technologies coming on board. We have computers at our fingertips that can do things which were unimaginable even 10 or 15 years ago. And I think also hardware in terms of optics and imaging that exists, I think that these hardware are getting much, much cheaper. So things that couldn't be done before, we can bring these technologies together and they can now be done to help oncologists. I think to engage patients, we need to demystify a lot of what we are doing. And I think this is an age-old problem in medicine. Doctors are scary people wearing white coats, talking a language that the common man doesn't understand. And I think that more and more we need to adapt our language and think about the people that we're talking. But technology has already brought this in. I see now oncologists who record their explanations to patients when they give it to them, so that the patients, when they're in shock, they can go home and listen to it later. And we should use these technologies which are at our fingertips to help make digesting the information more easily, and should help the patient understand the issues which they're confronted with. I work for CSEM, which is a technology transfer company sponsored by the Swiss government. And so what we try to do is take the latest technologies and transfer them to local Swiss or European companies. This is a project that we have with Althexis, which is in Cyprus. And the idea is to take rather simple hardware. And in here we have an imager with different lights at different colors. And what this allows us to do is help detect skin conditions, particularly skin cancer. So the idea would be that you would take such a system and you would place it onto your skin, and then it would scan at different wavelengths or take images at different colors. And this would allow us to pull out the information as to whether you have skin cancer or not. And this information is actually ascertained by having a machine learning algorithm, so an artificial intelligence algorithm embedded into the hardware, which will allow the detection of the cancer or some other skin conditions such as psoriasis or eczema. And the way this works is that you really need, first of all, to have a good collaboration with the oncologists, who will take many, many images and they will label whether it's cancer or not. We will train the hardware, the machine learning algorithm, and then from this, it will be able to help the doctors predict whether you have cancer or not. It won't replace the doctor. It is an aid for the doctor to help them predict whether you have cancer. Obviously, the final decision will rest with the doctor.